My name is Kian Alai, and today I'll be showing you how you can integrate your FileMaker solution with MailChimp. First, you'll need to follow the steps in the article to create your MailChimp account and generate your API keys. Once you've generated your key, go ahead and enter it into the field here, and enter the audience ID that you can find through the instructions in the article. Then, enter the email that you'd like to push, and hit the Push to MailChimp button. On a successful sync, you'll see a body that's similar to this appear in this results. Now, if we take a look at our MailChimp account, we can see that my email has been added to the audience right here. Now, let's go ahead and take a look at how we did this. Opening up the scripts, we'll start here. We've hard-coded the endpoint. You can reference this in the MailChimp developer docs. If this does ever change, it would have to be updated here. However, they typically give out pretty good notice for that. We load the audience ID and the email into variables, and we use that to build our full URL. Where we have the endpoint, we concatenate it with lists, audience ID, members, and email. MailChimp recently renamed list ID to audience ID, so that's why you may see lists and audience sort of used interchangeably. We then create our data package, which is in JSON format. All we're passing here is an email address and a status. You can pass other fields such as first and last name, mailing addresses, and you can also set up custom fields and set those as well. We then set up our authentication, which is quite literally any string concatenated with the MailChimp API key. Once we have all of that, we set up our curl. We're going to use a put request here. We then put the authentication in the header and we load the data. We use put because this can create or update records that are in MailChimp. They have calls that can only create and calls that can only update, but for the purposes of this, we went ahead and used put. We then use the insert from URL script step, specify the URL. Definitely make sure we automatically encode it as we'll be pushing in at symbols from the email. And then we specify our curl. We then check if there is an error. If there was no error, that means FileMaker was able to make the call successfully. However, that doesn't always mean that the email was added and subscribed. In the case that somebody unsubscribes from a list or an audience using the unsubscribe button at the bottom of emails that are sent, MailChimp will update the status in that list or that audience as unsubscribed. If an email's status is unsubscribed, the MailChimp API will not allow you to update it to be subscribed. Reason for this is you're essentially spamming people with emails that they don't want. So in the case that that happens, an error will get passed back in the response. It is actually in the detail object, which is where we grab it from, and then we display it here. After that, we just load the result into the result variable or into the result field for you to reference. So this is how you integrate and push emails from FileMaker to MailChimp. If you have any questions, feel free to fill out our contact us form on our website or just give us a call. Happy developing.